राम राम नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल टू संस्कृत श्री पाठमाला 1 सेशन 36. टुडे वी विल डू सम रिवीजन एंड इफ देयर आर एनी डाउट्स वी विल क्लेरिफाई देम. लेट अस बिगिन विद मंगल श्लोकः. शुक्लां वरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये. गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. आज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिम् आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवमुपास्महे. सरस्वती नमस्तेऽस्तु वीणा पुस्तकधारिणि हंसवाहनमारूढे विद्यादानं कुरुष्व मे. So we will look at a subhashitam today and then proceed. Yanti nyaya pravrittasya tiryanchopi sahayatam apanthanam tu gacchantam sodaropi vimunchati. The meaning is, even animals, tiryanchaha means an animal. So even an animal will help a person who treads the path of righteousness. And apanthanam, those who do not follow the path of righteousness will be forsaken even by their own brothers. So we know that in Ramayana even squirrels help Rama because he is a righteous person, whereas Ravana, even Vibhishana leaves them in the last moment. So even brothers forsake those who tread the path of unrighteousness is what this Subhashitam conveys. So today, initially I thought we'll do a complete revision, but since the practice test will have lesson 32 as the portion, I thought we could do some parts of lesson 32. But before that, if you have any doubts, I will start addressing them. Otherwise, we can just go with lesson 32 and try to complete it today. So if there are any questions, you can type them out in the chat box. Okay, you want to ask them. Jayanti 1965, one moment, I'll just unmute you. Jayanti 1965, I've unmuted you.
Ram Ram Ram, ma'am.
Ram Ram, namaste.
Ma'am, I have a few doubts, I've marked them. Can you give me a chance in about 5 minutes after somebody else so I can pick them all out and keep it ready?
Okay, you need some time. Sure, I'll call you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sarita Singh.
Sarita Singh, unmuted. Okay. Hi, Ram Ram. I wanted to very quickly ask. The Yara, Lama, Sasha, Sama are all auxiliary letters. Are they all called Ayogavahas?
They are not Ayogavahas.
They are not Ayogavahas at all.
No. Ayogavahas are Anuswara, Visarga, and Padmaniyaha.
Those four. Okay.
Yes.
Now, all right. Thank you. If a word has Guntakshara and Sunuktakshara, how will it be classified? For example, as a Mukta. So Mukta has.
Yes, Takara and Takara together. So when two consonants occur immediately after each other, they are Sanyuktaksharas.
Yes.
So a consonant with a vowel is a Gunitakshara. Consonants can necessarily be used only in combination with vowels.
Okay, so in Mukta, so after the ta is not a vitahalant, it's a whole ta. So will it be called vitamatra or not?
Sorry, I didn't get your question. Your audio is not very clear.
Oh, sorry.
Can you talk a little slowly?
Okay, in the word Mukta, there is the same word. So it's a ma halant or a ma plus plus halant ta, half ta,
yes,
half ma and a.
Okay.
So the ta is having the half ta and full and the a with it, right?
Yeah. So it is a sayukta.
So it will be called a Sayuktakshara. It will only when it has other vowels will it be called a Gurutakshara.
Yes. For example, when we say Gunitakshara, Gu has Gakara and Ukara, so that is a Gunitakshara.
Okay. Okay.
And similarly, Ni has Nakara and Ikara, so that again is a Gunitakshara.
Okay. So, in the Karkash, Shansha, Sa, Akarkash sounds.
Yes, yes.
Akara is a Mridu Vyanjana, Mridu Vyanjana.
Yes, Hakara is a Mridu Vyanjana.
Okay. And Anuswar, and you said that's a Vaha. Okay. What will Cha and Uchra. So, and the Repha, when Repha comes before the consonant, it goes on the top.
Yes. It becomes the curve on the top.
And when it comes after, it becomes a R at the bottom of the letter, of the consonant.
Yeah. It is a slanting line at the bottom of the consonant.
Okay, and just one last one because I will have more later on, but so far. So, when we listen for pond, we say paraga. So, is it a padaga, dakara, or rakara? Is it a paraga or padag?
Tatagaha is also there, tatakaha is also there. So, both forms, even tadakaha is there, tatakaha is also there.
Oh.
So, they are all correct forms of the word.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Dhanyavaad.
Dhanyavaad. Ramya Bhagini, do you have any doubts?
Namaskara, ma'am.
Namaskara.
I had a doubt regarding the Natvam.
Okay.
There is, in the textbook on page 62-63, there are a couple of cases where the English sentence is Malati lives with Krishna,
yes,
which is Malati Krishnena Saha Vasati.
Yes.
Now, how will I know if it is to be, in this case, the Krishnena can also happen. The Natvam rule will work for it to say na. But why do I not use it here?
It is Krishnena, it is Nakara only. In Krishna, the first is a Nakara and the second is a Nakara.
Correct. But right. If I was going to use I would say there are other cases where I would use na also, right? In the other vibhaktis,
see,
I would think.
In this particular word, there is the shakara. Hmm. Then there is the na.
Right.
Already the natvam has happened for the nakara. So na is Krishna, right?
Right.
So that inhibits the second na from getting the natva.
Okay. Yes.
You should not have intervening letters, and the only exceptions are the kavarga, the kavarga,
and
hayavarga.
Yes.
So this nakara will prevent the second na from getting anatva.
So okay, when I was using in the panchami vibhakti, it would be Krishnam. No, what? Krishna
panchami. Panchami, panchami. Is Krishna, Krishnabhyam, Krishnebhyah.
Shashti would be Krishnaya, Krishna Yoho, Krishnanam.
Krishna Yoho,
Krishna. Krishnanam, but there it would also be Krishnanam then.
Yes, it is.
Okay, the Krishna. Second one would always be Na because of the first one.
Yes.
All right, I understood that. Yes, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So today I said I will be giving details about the test, the final exam on the October 5th. I will do that. And you will also receive a detailed email about the final exam. That is on October 5th, so we still have time for that. JMT is ready. Okay. Janani Putra is in brackets. Hasta Bhyam Upaguhate. Ya Upaguhati. So this is Upaguhate is an Atmanepada verb. So in the textbook, even though we have not learned Atmanepada yet, there are some verbs like Rochate, Labhate, which are ending in Te. So it is a different kind of a verb which we will see later. But for now, just understand Upaguhate is embraces. So, Janani Putram Hastabhyam Upaguhate. Kra is a Sanyuktakshara, but how do you call Kra? So, Kakara and the Shakara followed by Akara. So it is a Sanyuktakshara, Gunitakshara of the Sanyuktakshara. So Ka and Sha alone is a Sanyuktakshara. To that we add a vowel and then it becomes a Gunitakshara. Because Sanyuktakshara at some point you have to add a vowel. So it will become a Gunitakshara later. So you add the matras like A, Ki Matra and all that. So later on it becomes a Gunitakshara. What is the meaning of yatra kutra? Yatra kutra means wherever. Yatra kutra api gachati. So saha, he goes wherever he wants. He goes to any place. Is yatra kutra. Kati horaha gataha means what is the time now or how many hours have elapsed? How much time has passed? Prahladaha Bhagavata Rakshitaha. How? So this Bhagavata is Bhagavan, Bhagavat Shabda. So the forms will be Bhagavan, Bhagavanto, Bhagavantaha, which we have not learnt yet. We have only learnt the vowel ending nouns. So for now, don't worry too much about it. Just note that Bhagavata is the Tritiya Vibhakti. So by Bhagavan Prahlada was protected. Yes, today there is supposed to be a revision, but since many had doubts, we thought we'll clear the doubts first. We can go on with the revision today if there is time, as well as on 23rd. Can you explain the use of sixth case vibhakti? Sixth case is used for showing, indicating possession of. So, Sita Ramasya Patni. So, Ramasya is sixth case singular. It means of Rama, Rama's wife. Okay, we will discuss lesson 32 today. We will do that. Bharavahaha shirasa bharam vahati. How? Again, shiras is a sakaranta shabda. So shirasa is the tritiya vibhakti. That again is not something that we have learnt. So just note this particular word, shirasa is tritiya vibhakti of shiras, is what you have to learn now. I will go to Jayanti again. Ram Ram.
Thank you, ma'am. Yes. Ma'am, in this exercise 27, there were about 120 sentences, almost 100 sentences.
Lesson 27, you mean, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
The instrumental case.
Okay.
So in the translation, there's one sentence which says, Charmakaraha Charmana Upanahe Rachayati.
Which is the number of the sentence?
Number 63, ma'am.
63. In 27.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Charmakaraha
Charmana Upanhau Rachayati.
Yeah,
Upanhau
Rachayati. Okay.
So the Charmakaraha is in the first Pratama Vibhakti.
Yes.
The Charmana is which Vibhakti? It should be second. Will it be like, I don't understand
so,
that.
With leather. So with leather will be in Tritiya Vibhakti. This again is in consonant ending noun, which is Charman Shabdaha. Mm-hmm. So it Tritiya becomes Charmana.
But this is Tritiya, isn't it? Instrumental.
Instrumental. Sorry. Is Tritiya.
Tritiya, yeah, yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes. So it's instrumental case of Charman Shabdaha. So it is Charmana.
Okay, Charman. And the
other revision exercises, there are many words and many prayogas which are, using concepts which have not been introduced to you till now.
Yes, ma'am.
So, just you can go through it cursorily. You don't have to worry too much about the revision exercises. Look at the simple sentences, and wherever you can, grasp the meaning of such irregular words, do it.
Ma'am, sometimes when we don't, like, there are certain verbs we have not even learned, right?
So exactly.
It's very difficult for us to, like, understand that. So I just go to the, like, translation where they have given the key, and I just looked at it and yes. I did
by. So what you can do is wherever the verbs, you're able to identify the regular forms of the verbs, like it has anti,
yeah,
lat lakara,
yes,
or if it has patatu patatam patantu, or if it has the lot lakara forms, you know those forms. So
yes,
if it is similar to that, note the verb alone for the meaning.
Yes, ma'am. Like prayachati, we haven't learned.
Take a list of such verbs. Yes, prayachati is to give.
Yes,
just
ma'am.
Like yachati, it is prayachati is just he gives wholeheartedly. So prayachati.
But it says exchanges black gram for sesame. So in the which
that is prati yachati must be.
No, it just says tilebhya mashan prayachati.
Oh, tilebhya masha. So there itself, the indication of returning has or exchange has been given the sentence.
Oh, okay.
So it depends entirely on the context based on which you have to understand this.
Okay, ma'am. The other question was balakebhya pustakani vitarati. This is from the lesson 28.
Okay, this is Chaturthi Vibhakti.
Correct. So in that, I wrote the books are distributed to the boys or by the boys.
To the boys, because to Chaturthi the is native case. So two and four will be indicated by Chaturthi Vibhakti.
So this is Balakebhyah. So the boys, right? It means
yes,
boys.
To the boys, books are being distributed.
Okay. So in another question is Ramaya Halani Rochante. Why would it be Rochante, ma'am?
Because to be to some of to someone's liking is Rochate. So it has to be with a Halani.
Oh, okay, okay. So it is. Oh, because it's fruits, it is rochante, is it? That's why it's bahuvachana.
Yes. So in this sentence, the subject is phalani. That's why the verb, which is rochante, agrees with phalani.
So the sentence will be like Rama likes fruits or fruits are liked by Rama? How does it work?
It's not fruits are liked by Rama. You have to imagine that fruits are doing an action of being liked by Rama.
Ah, okay. But the sentence is Rama likes fruits, right?
Yes. So in Sanskrit, we have this prayoga where rochate means to be to someone's liking.
Correct. That's what you told us. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. That's all. These two only I had, like these three, four sentences I had doubts. Thank you, ma'am. Ram, Ram, Ram. Dhanyavada.
Example, some sentences do not have verbs explicitly. For example, page 56-9. Page 56-2-9. Dash ubhayataha chhatraha santi. Yes, you can supply the verbs. So, Acharyaha is the word given in bracket. So, when Ubhayataha comes, we use the Dvitiya Vibhakti. So, Acharyam Ubhayataha Chhatraha Santi will be the complete sentence. Yatate means tries. And that again is an Atmanepada verb, but just learn the meaning that yatate means he tries. Kati horaha, for that you can also say how much time it took. It entirely depends on the context. If they are talking about some action, it could mean how much time it has taken. Question 6, decline the case forms. Vatsala Jambunathan Bhagini, can you explain which lesson this is in? Question 6. M.K. Janaki. Please let me know the meaning of conjugate the verbs from lesson 32. I didn't understand your question. Just give me a minute. M.K. Janaki, I've unmuted you. You're self-muted. You can unmute yourself and ask your question.
Unmuted. Ma, namaste.
Namaste.
Ram, Ram, conjugate the following verb to flee from the lesson 32. Thavadi, chaladi, kridadi, upyadi, likhadi, etc. Thavadi, conjugate meaning that
conjugate means you have to write all the forms. That is, there are 9 forms, isn't it? Prathama Purusha, Madhyama Purusha. So all the 9 forms.
Dhavati,
etc.
Oh yes, thank you. Thank you.
Do we have to write all the case forms or only one? So I think there is a question in lesson 32 which requires you to write all the case forms. So you have to write all the 24 forms, including the Sambodhana Prathama. The answers to lesson 32 have not been uploaded, but if you have any specific doubts, we can clarify them now. So samprati, there is a doubt that samprati, the anuswara is not used after sakara, whereas in sampradana, anuswara is used. So within a word, you can either use the anuswara or you can use the makara itself. So you have the option of using makara or the anuswara. But at the end of a word, when it is followed by a consonant, you use only the anuswara. When it is followed by a vowel or when it is the end of the sentence itself, then you use the makara. Yes, so samyak, samyat, all these things, since it's inside a verb, within a word, you have the choice of using either the anuswara or the makara. Once we go through the questions, we will start discussing lesson 32. Deenebhyaha, is it weak or poor? It again depends on the context. Deenaha can be someone who is helpless. So it could be either because of his weakness or because of his poverty. So again, only when you look at the context, you will know. So again, in a sentence, when you're saying dhanam yachati dine bhyaha, then it means probably that he is poor. In 31st lesson, there is a word sarasi, means in the pond. So that again is a saras is a sakaranta shabda and sarasi is the saptami ekavachanam. This again, we have not learned so far, so don't worry too much about it. Just know that sarasi is the locative case. This rochante, I will check in it. I think Jayanti 1965, you had that doubt. So can you, some student wants to know where this rochante appears. So if you have it ready at hand, you can just type it in the chat box and I can let her know. Rite means without or except. Just like Vina, we can use Rite, Krishnena Rite or Krishnena Vina. Ayushman Bhava. So what is the doubt in that? 32.7 says conjugate verbs. So yes, you have to write all the verb forms in Lat Lakaraha. In the 9 forms in the Lat Lakaraha. Mashti is the kajal which is used. So mashya means either the kajal or the ink in the pen is also called mashi. So mashya is the tritiya vibhakti. So with the ink is what is meant. Lesson 28, sentence 7 has this phalani ramaya rochante. Ramaya phalani rochante. So that is the sentence, lesson 28, sentence 7. Is the sentence wrong if the subject appears first in the sentence? For example, phalani, no, the sentence is still, the sentence will mean the same and it is correct. So why is it not chakraihi and why is it chakrabhyam? Because normally ratha has two chakras, so that's why it is chakrabhyam. Okay, I think many people have doubts in lesson 32. Okay, there is also a request for uploading the answers of lesson 32. I will try to upload it in a day or two. Okay. Someone says they have a doubt. Padma. Padma Bhagini, I have unmuted you. You have
unmuted. Hi. Ram Ram Bhagini.
Yeah.
This 32 lesson, shall I start or we will be revising now? Whatever doubts I have,
I ask? You can just ask me if you have doubts. Because I am doubtful if we can complete the lesson completely today.
32.3, sentence 15.
Sentences are not numbered, right? Can you tell me which sentence?
Vasaya graha sajjam kuru.
Yes.
It will take the Tritiya Vibhakti Griham, Bhagini.
It is Dvitiya Vibhakti because get the house ready for residing, right? So the house becomes the object in the sentence. So it is Dvitiya Vibhakti.
Griham.
So Griham, Grihe, Grihani. Griham again is Dvitiya Vibhakti, also is Griham.
No, this Vasaya, na, that is what form is it?
It is Vasa. Chaturthi. That is Chaturthi Vibhakti of Vasaha.
Vasaha, okay.
Yes. So that means residence or for residing. Since it indicates the purpose, it is in Chaturthi Vibhakti. When we use for, we use the Chaturthi Vibhakti, right? So Vasaya is the Chaturthi Vibhakti.
And then in the same, there is a 20th sentence, buddhihi vidyaya vilasati. Vidyaya form will be correct, right?
Correct. So by education or by learning, the brain, vilasati is shines. So you sharpen your brain by education.
And then in the discussion also this doubt was there, the 26th sentence, nadi pravaha adhuna manda bhavati.
Yes, so there shashti also can be used, saptami is also okay. Nadyam pravaha or nadyaha pravaha, both are okay.
Nadyam and?
Saptami and shashti, both are okay.
Okay, okay.
Nadyam is saptami, nadyaha is shashti.
And then the jata yoga samaksham ravanam sitam apaharata.
Yes.
Is it correct from jata yoga?
Jata yuhu. So it is like guru. So guruhu is shashti, right? So you have to use the Shashti Vibhakti because it is off, in front of Jatayu's eyes. So since it is off, we are using the Shashti Vibhakti. It is Jatayu, just like Guru.
Then there is a sentence 34. Acharya Vyakaranam Patha. I was not able to complete because I was not able to get the meaning. Vyakaranam, grammar, read the grammar.
Yes. From the
of
teacher.
From the teacher.
Yes.
Oh.
Acharyat Vyakaranam Patha.
Acharyat. Okay. Another next sentence. Kasturi Harina Jayate. I mean, Kasturi is also deer. Harina.
Kasturi is not deer. Kasturi is the substance that is the, it is the fragrance that is obtained from the musk, which is obtained from the deer, right? So,
okay.
From the deer is Harina. Harina is the shabda. It is an akaranta shabda, so Harinath will be the panchami ekavachana.
Okay. Lalan balaha santosham labhate.
Yes, labhate is gets or obtains. So he becomes happy. The child becomes happy by pampering. So lalanat, lalanam is the shabda.
Lalanam, is it? Though we are not able to find this shabda. So
all you have to do is to look up the lalana shabda in a dictionary. You will know that whether it is a, you know that it's akara ending shabda because lalana is given. So akara ending shabda, which if it's a napumsaka linga, it will be lalanam. If it is full linga, it will be lalana. You have to just look it up in the dictionary in that way.
Okay.
We know only the akaranta ending, the vowel ending shabdas as of now. So it cannot be lalan. There is no halanta there.
Lalan.
Yes.
Simha bhayam bhavati. That is
again,
your
When there is bhayam or bhitihi or any fear that is indicated, we use fear of in the sense of panchami.
Okay.
Simhat bhayam bhavati.
Simhat. Okay.
Yes.
There is a sentence to be used, you make sentences. I just wanted to doubt whether I have a doubt whether we have to use the same verb form, is it?
The same verb form is preferable, yes.
Okay. Now, Sangachati means there are two rivers come together. Then it becomes yes. Sangachandi, no? That plural, I mean, or see, Sangachati, I wanted to make a sentence. Varanasi. Okay.
Yes. Varanasyam. Because it is a Ikaranta Srilinga Shabda. Varanasyam. So Saptami will be like Sitayam or Nadyam, it will be Varanasyam. Okay, what is your sentence?
I wanted to say Ganga Yamuna cha Sangachanti, Ganga and Yamuna.
So it will be Sangachataha. It will be Dvivachana.
Okay. So see, when there is a meeting, no, there are two things involved. So I am not able yes. to use the sentences Sangachadi.
Sangachadi, you
use a singular, no?
Ganga Yamunaya Sangachadi. So Ganga joins with Yamuna.
Yamunaya.
Or Yamuna Gangaya Sah Gangaya Sangachadi.
Okay.
So when one joins the other one will be in singular.
Okay. Again, that yachate is a form of...
That is an Atmanepada form. Yachate is to beg.
Because we are supposed to make use in sentence again.
Yeah, labhate is given.
The 32.5.
Okay.
One second.
Yes, yachate is given.
Yachate is given for using in making sentence.
Yes. So yachate is to beg.
Yeah.
Yes. So, Bhikshukaha Dhanikar Dhanam Yachate.
Excuse me, what? Then?
Bhikshukaha is a beggar. Or Yachakaha. Dhanikat from the wealthy person. He asks for wealth. Or he begs for wealth.
Okay. So, but Yachate is not the form which we have learned so far, no?
We have not learned so far. So don't worry too much about it. Yachate, I think, has come in one of the lessons, so they have given it here.
Okay. Mahyam is meaning means.
Mahyam is Asmad Shabda, Chaturthi Vibhakti, Ekavachana. To me or for me.
Oh, that for me. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Then meaning of padapaha means, is it something to do with the leg, padapaha?
Padapaha is again a vrikshaha. Vrikshaha or a tree is padapaha because it drinks from the roots, isn't it? Padena pibati iti padapaha. By its legs, it takes in the water and nutrients, right? So, it is padapaha.
So, meaning is a tree?
Tree, yes.
Okay. We have to translate. The lion is an enemy to the elephant.
Yes. So here you may have to replace it with of because you have to use shashti. So Simha Gajasya Shatruhu.
Shatruhu. Okay. Okay, then there is some similar sentences are there.
Any other doubt, madam?
Only one more. so question sentence was there. Okay, well,
okay, if you come across it, you can type your
question. Just send across a message. Okay, thank you so much. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada. Lalita, Balaji, you have no doubts. Vatsala, Jambunathan, you want to be unmuted? What? So, Lalita, Balaji, and Vatsala, Jambunathan. Vatsala Jambunathan Bhagini.
Hello. Namaskar Bhagini.
Namaskar.
Ram Ram. Yeah, I was going through some of the practice sentences and in the last lesson, there is sentence number, lesson number 32.
Okay.
32, number 6, decline the following words in the required cases. So they say Sita, fourth means to give the fourth vibhakti of Sita.
Yes.
So that will be Sita and Sita Bhyam Sita Bhyaha.
No, Chaturthi in Sri Linga, how is it? Sita Yai.
Sita Yai, Sita Bhyam, Sita
Yoho. Sita Bhyaha.
Sita Bhyaha, okay. So Sita, there I get confused between the Sri Linga Vibhakti and
Pulling. Akaranta, no, Akaranta Shabda is only Sri Linga. So it will be similar to Sita Shabda or Rama Shabda. So if you know okay. either of them, then you can do all the Akaranta Sri Linga Shabdas.
Ata, Rama and Sita.
Yeah.
Second question is conjugate the following davati, then you have to say davati, davataha, davantaha. Is that the one that we are supposed to do?
Yes.
For all the nine forms.
All the nine.
And then then they give the meanings of what is krimi be? Krimi, krimi, krimihi or krimi? The phrenic one after Madhukraha. Krimihi. Mayuraha.
Is an insect. After Mayuraha, is it?
Ah, Krimihi.
Krimihi is an insect.
Give the meaning of the following word.
It is an insect.
Insect of the Krimi, or the insect. Okay. Yes. And then Britakaha will be? Britakaha.
Britakaha is a servant, a person who helps, a helper.
Servant, okay, okay. Okay, the others, I think I know most of them. And then this asmasu means live long, is it? Or how do you say for asmasu?
Asmasu is asmad shabda saptami bahu vachanam. So in us. Is it given in this exercise or is it, where is it from?
No, it's given the meaning of the words. No, given the meaning of the word, last sentence. Asmasu, oh, okay. Then yesha.
Asmasu is in us. So it is saptami vibhakti, so it is locative. So in, on, at, among, about, these are the prepositions with which you can use it. So in us is the most common usage.
But what is the meaning we give for the word? When you say give in the meaning us, of the word asmasu, what do you write for it?
You can just write in us.
Okay.
I-N.
And
you in us.
Okay, in us. Okay, okay. And then in sentence number sixth one on web, exercise number 30, exercise number 30, genitive case. Lesson number 30, genitive case sentence structure.
Okay.
In that sixth one, Ramuhu swadhyasya hota anna Annapanam gachati. What does it mean? How do we say that?
Ramahu. It is not swa. It is khadyasya hetohu. It means for the purpose of eating. Khadyam is something that can be eaten. So eatable.
Yeah, khadya.
Okay. So for getting khadyam, which is an eatable, he goes to an annapanam. Apanam is a shop. Annapanam is a canteen or a hotel or a restaurant or a place where you get food. So annapanam gachati. So khadyasya hetuhu is for the purpose of. Hetuhu is the cause. So just like guru, here it is hetoho is the panchami vibhakti ekavachana. Guroho hetoho.
That is why we are unable to decipher how to put that words correctly and give the meaning.
Yes.
So it is a translation.
The sentences in the revision exercises are very they are not of this standard. So you can just go through them cursorily, and then if there are any sentences of your level, then you can learn them. If you're able to grasp the words in the words, then it is good. Otherwise, don't bother too much.
Okay. Because some of the words we have done in our exercise in our textbook as we are going through. So yes. Though, but here some of them are a little confusing.
Yes. Because some saptami vibhakti, sati saptami prayogas and all have been given, which are completely not meant for this level. So and we have to learn all the kridantas to learn sati saptami. So that is not possible at this stage.
And then there were previous on 29, number 22, he gets prestige from charity.
Previous number 29. Oh, let's sentence.
English translation. He gets prestige from charity.
Yes. So what is your doubt in that?
No, there is a Dhanat Paramam Priyam Na Asti. Is that the answer for that?
No, it is Dhanat Sammanam Labhate.
But here it is given the answer and the keys to each of them. They don't match.
See, 22nd sentence is Dhanat Sammanam Labhate. And the answer keys is he gets prestige from charity. They definitely match. What is the problem in that?
I was looking at, I think
you're looking at a wrong sentence.
Yes. Yeah, okay, sorry. I think I'm trying to understand now with the help of these, each of the case sentences, the vibhakti is much better.
Yes.
When you say ablative case means, so the corresponding Sanskrit will be Prathama, Dvitiya, Tritiya, so that we have to make a note of it against each of them. What is the meaning of ablative? So
ablative is when there is a separation. The thing from which an object is separated will be in Panchami Vibhakti.
Okay. So ablative is Panchami Vibhakti.
Yes.
Okay. That was, I'm just trying to correlate the Vibhakti with the English word and the Sanskrit word.
No, so it is enough if you know the Sanskrita Vibhakti name, as in Prathama, Dvitiya, etc. So you don't have to
But in the sentence, the structure that is given here, they say ablative case sentence structure. So again, I don't understand how the ablative.
Okay. So there are just seven words, right? So subject, object, instrumental, dative, ablative, then genitive, then locative.
And so then you genitive have will be
genitive is
Ramasya.
Ramasya, exactly.
Shashti. Genitive Shashti.
Yes.
So I have to keep a table over there and then keep on referencing to which one is what.
Yeah.
That makes a little difficult. Otherwise, I am trying to understand whatever I can. And the declination form. And then the form Subhyam, that also is a little confusing. How to understand that Shabda?
You have to learn the forms. That is the Yushmat Shabda. Just like other Shabdas, it has to just... you have to get it into your memory.
when you are learning and application of it into the sentence form, how does
so
it?
So anywhere where the chaturthi or dvitiya vibhakti is used, it is a similar usage. Whether it is yushmat shabda or asmat shabda, it is the same case.
Okay. Thank you.
Dhanyavad. Ram Ram.
Oh, Ram Ram.
Okay, somebody wants me to explain Lot Lakaraha with examples. In lesson 32, third question for some words, the appropriate forms, I have doubts. Okay, Usha, I will unmute you in a bit. Lesson 30. So, salutations to father and mother in Sanskrit is Mata Pitribhyam, or if you want to say it separately, you have to say Matre Pitrecha Namaha. So, that is again a Rikarantha Shabda, we have not learnt it. So, you can say Mata Pitribhyam. Sajjam is ready. So the quality of being ready is sajjam. It's an adjective. So when it is used with a neuter gender word, it will be sajjam. If it is a strilinga pada, it will be sajji and sajjaha for pullinga. Kshirabdihi means the ocean of milk. Kshirabdihi. Kshira is milk. Abdihi is an ocean. If you're unable to take the exam on the 4th, I will let you know shortly whether you will be able to, you'll be given a second chance of whether a second test will be conducted for those who are not able to take the exam on the 4th. So once I get a proper communication from the academic council, I will communicate that to you. Sahapathakaha is a fellow student. Can it be lalaneena? It can be lalaneena. Usually, the hetu or the cause can either be in tritiya or in panchami. Lalaneena or lalanath. So, by lalanam or with lalanam. Both are correct. Meaning of alingati is to embrace or hug. Lesson 32, a whole lot of new words that we did not get the meanings from you. Okay, lesson 32, I think if possible, I will try to upload the answers in a day or two. The exam is online. So there is, you just have, it's a usual multiple choice questions. And this time it will be from the website itself. The practice test has already been uploaded, but you will be able to access it only on the 21st. Spardha means, spardha is competition. And Kshirabdhi, I told you, is the ocean of milk. In me is mai. So you have to know the asmad shabda. Mai avayoho asmasu is the saptami form. I'll go back to. Okay, Usha, mute your phone. Usha Bhagini.
You can see. Ram Ram.
Ram Ram. Namaste.
Namaste. In lesson 32, the third Roman numeral, complete the following sentences using proper forms of the words given within the brackets. In that, the 21st or 20th, Krishnah Samanah Virah Na Bhavati. So,
yes.
So will it be Sashti?
When Samanah comes, we say you're trying to equate somebody with Krishna. You cannot compare anybody with Krishna is what they are trying to say. So, Krishnena Samanaha or Krishnena Tulyaha. So, it will be Tritiya.
Okay. And then Vinaya Vidya Vardhate.
Yes. So, Vinayena, that again, when the cause is to be expressed, you use either Vinayat or Vinayena, either Tritiya or Panchami.
Okay.
So we can say by or from Vinaya, we get the Vidya develops or the knowledge develops, or you can say because of humility, knowledge improves.
Okay. Then Vrishti, Vrishti Jalam Rate. So it is Panchami then?
Panchami. So Vrishtihi is like Matihi. So Ikaranta Sriling Shabda. So you can say Vrishtehe or Vrishtyaha. Yaha Matehe. So Vrishtyaha, Vrishtehe. Both are correct.
Yeah. In cases where we are able to do either the third or the fifth. So, if we write any one, it will be correct, right?
Anyone should do. Anyone should. Okay.
It is not like this is the appropriate one. Like
both are equally. So, for this context, both Tritiya and Panchami are correct.
Okay. Dhanyavadaha. Ram Ram.
Ram Ram. Dhanyavadaha. I think we've already run out of time. So, I'll stop here. What I'll do is I'll try to upload the suggested answers, at least for the difficult portions of the lesson 32. So I hope you would have all received the email regarding the test on the 21st. It is just a practice test. It will be open for you to take it anytime till the exam, final exam on October 5th. And regarding the October 5th exam, I will send you the complete details by email and wish you all the best. We will stop here with the Mangalashloka. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramaya. सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ओम शांति 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 धन्यवादः शुभरात्रिः